You look like a man who's looking for some mostly fresh animal parts? I don't know. Celia usually buys whatever I have, and Mr. Pickett seemed real interested. So I thought maybe I was onto something.
Mr. Pickett? Franklin Pickett from Edgewater?
That's him. He'd been here years, but he always talked about going back to Edgewater one day.
Sure. Mr. Pickett used to run the community center outside Edgewater. He had this grand idea to make it a museum for Halcyon life. As my dad told it, Mr. Pickett was always going on about getting a Manta Queen for the last display. He left the Vale, gosh, years ago.
He came to Stellar Bay years ago, just before the board cut us off. Ended up stuck here. He was always real interested in our monsters. Manta Queens, especially. Sure, they're real big. Hard to miss them. Well, I could send you to the same place I sent Mr. Pickett. But I haven't seen him in a few weeks. To tell true, I'm starting to get a bit worried about him.
Captain, can we look for him? I'd feel awful if somebody from home was in trouble and we didn't do nothing.
Tell you what, I'll tell you where I sent Mr. Pickett if you promise to look for him. Help him out if he's got himself in trouble. Fair deal? All right then, leave town through the southern gate, the one right here, and head past the abandoned ruins. Last Manta Queen I saw was in the wilds out that-a-ways. Could be Mr. Pickett still out there too. Yeah, you find him yet? I sent him past the ruins just south of town. He was hunting for a Manta Queen out there.
Thank you for stopping. Everyone acts like nothing's wrong, like my little boy isn't at risk of being eaten by some vile creature. Please, you have to help me get my little Tucker back. He ran away and is going to get himself killed. Oh, I just know a Raptodon is melting him with acid as we speak. Oh, I just knew you were a good person. Agnes, I said, this is the man to save your little Tucky. And I was right. He ran out into the wilderness a few days ago. I warned him about the raptodons, mantisaurs and marauders, the toxic sulfur pools and poisonous plants, but he didn't listen.
Oh, law, Captain. A youngster won't last long in a place like this. Please, can't we help?
Please, won't you go and find my boy? He's been pining for an adventure. Says he's tired of living cooped up behind the walls. But he doesn't understand how dangerous it is out there. I warned him. A Raptodon would snap him up first chance it got. I just know one's ripped his arm off and is gnawing on his sweet little fingers. He should have listened to his mama. I promised I'd keep him safe here with me. He's been listening to those awful broadcasts that the iconoclasts put out. I begged Sanjar to put a stop to them, but did he? No! And now I just know my boys run off to Amber Heights. That is, if a Manta Queen hasn't spooled out and eaten his entrails for breakfast already! Those low-life degenerates, leading innocent boys into a life of danger. Oh, they make it sound so exciting, like it's noble to risk it all out there, fighting for the greater good.
Not sure I'm seeing the problem here.
You're one of them, aren't you? You should be ashamed of yourself, young man, just as your mama would be. How noble is it to worry your loved ones? Not at all, I say. But still they preach their sermons of anarchy and rebellion to anyone who listened. If they weren't holed up in Amber Heights, I'd knock them all upside the head. That old settlement, southwest of Stellar Bay. I don't know which is worse, the thought of my son shacking up with the nutty iconoclasts, or that he never made it. Sprats could be nesting in his rotting body alongside the road as we speak. Or maybe Marauders got him, pulled all his teeth out, crushed him into their drugs and made him snort them. Oh, the things that could happen to my sweet baby. Thank you. Oh, I know he'll be safe now that someone's able to fetch him home. You look for him in Amber Heights, you hear? It's down the road southwest of town. I'm sure he made it that far. I just know it. And if you find any of them iconoclasts indoctrinating my boy, you punch them in the mouths. Tell them what I think of them luring little boys away from their mamas. It's immoral.
Thanks for helping MSI set things straight around here.
We don't get many outsiders.
Like those old Sundays when we'd unload Saltuna shipments at the cannon.
We gotta go exploring. I wanna see some savages.
Feels like the old bits outside of Edgewater. Used up, unneeded, left to settle into ruin.
Exploring some ruins, killing some monsters. All we're missing is theme music. Staying out of sight.
visitor? What an unexpected surprise! Please, come in. Come in.
We're armed to the teeth. What's he gonna do? Kill us with generosity?
That's the spirit. Now come in. Make yourselves comfortable. I'm afraid we don't get many visitors out here. The Raptodons and Marauders scare off all but the boldest. And if you've braved them, you must be exhausted. Why don't you stay for dinner? I'm sure I would remember something like that. Now, quit fretting yourself about that. Make yourself at home. Dinner's almost ready.
I think I just lost my appetite.
You must be famished. So are we, my friend, but one can't rush a fine meal. Is it sticking again? I'm afraid nothing out here works the way it used to. There's a bit of a trick to jimmying it open. I'll see to it once we've finished dinner. I do appreciate your patience. I'd hate to serve company with anything but the best, though.
What a pleasant surprise. And just when I was beginning to fear we'd seen the last of good company for a spell. Yet the Eternal provides, does it not? The Eternal does not desire that we huddle and hide, crowded in by walls. We all share the spark of the divine, and we were made to spread it across the stars. Out here, we are free. And even apart from society, the universe provides for us, as your being here proves. Just that your presence here is a gift to us, and one that we don't take for granted. Look at me, prattling on as if this gravy is going to cook itself. Why don't you run along until we are ready for dinner?
Oh, hi there. Did you come to bring us more of those rocket candies? You know, the ones that come in a bottle with a rocket ship on the front. They don't taste very good, but they make me feel so nice. Hungry, too. That's too bad. There was this other man who used to bring them. Not anymore, though. Mama and Papa said he came from the city. When we got sick one time, he brought those candies to make us well again. And they worked. Now we feel better than ever. Mama says they're a gift from the Eternal. He said they were making us sick. Mom and Papa got real mad at him for that. They went to have a talk with him. Afterwards, they said he wasn't coming back again. I don't know. I'm not really supposed to talk to strangers. Okay. Maybe I'll see you at dinner.
That was real nice of her, inviting us to dinner like that.
What are you doing in my room? Liar! You're trying to steal the last of my rocket candies, aren't you? The ones that come in a bottle with a rocket ship on it. Like the other man used to bring.
Yeah, I'm definitely gonna have nightmares about this.
I'm gonna be sick.
But what's this? You're tracking blood into the kitchen. Oh dear. You've been nosy, haven't you? Of course not. What better end for the day than a meal around the family table? And what more noble purpose for you than to bring us together? Now there's an intriguing prospect. Forgo the promise of a fine dinner now for others down the road. Martha, my dear, what do you say?
It seems the Eternal shall provide through our new friend.
And there we have it. Stop by any time, hmm? How good to see you again.
Oh, hello there. You come for dinner? Sorry, I'm not real good with, names. It just gets hard to remember things. I recall moments, feelings, but the details slip.
I felt like that after my dad passed. Walked around in a haze for weeks. I'm sorry you're feeling that way, too.
Other times, it's like there's fog. Sorry, have we talked about this before? That's nice of you. I usually feel better after I eat. Mama said dinner's almost ready, huh?
I have no doubt the Eternal will bless us through you.
space, there's choice pills that cure all your ills.
Here and a Mata Queen showed up, then Raptodons. It was a void blast mess. I ran in here and now the door's locked. Little help? It's easier than it sounds, all right? Next time you get chased by Raptodons, you let me know the rationality of your decisions. Phew. Thanks, mister. My buddy had a key, but I ain't heard him in a while. He locked me in here and took off. Probably got munched. So look for a dead guy, I guess. Or a rat. Maybe it's in a rat belly. Gross. Sure. Pete's not answering questions. Iconoclast runner. The iconoclast runner. Fast as we've got. Ain't a Raptodon on this void-forsaken hellhole that can catch me. I'm sorry. Put me in a tiny room like this and I'm liable to flip. Not keen on tight spaces, you know? Oh, that'd be my people. Graham and Zora and Milton and... I really miss them. Gonna let me out of here? I want to get back to Amber Heights. My buddy locked me in here. I told you that. It was for my safekeeping, on account of Raptodons wanting to munch on my head. But, I mean, okay, yes, fine. I get myself into sticky situations. It's just part of life, all right? Sometimes you gotta hide in a trash can so you don't get eaten by monsters. Neither was I. Who'd hide in a trash can? Gross. Probably. I don't know. When I try to read things, my mind gets to wandering about all the things I could be doing instead. Get me out of here! Oh, much obliged.
Thank you so much. It was getting all stuffy in there, and I was getting a mite lightheaded, and I think maybe I was gonna die. Now I'm out here, and I'm headed back to Amber Heights. Oh, sure, I'm a runner. I'm used to getting all dizzy, and hey, who's your identical, slightly blurry friend? I ain't got nothing on me. How's about a heaping helping of appreciation and respect? That's true. Okay, fine. Here. Thanks a lot, mister.
Don't mess with the best. Ruins? Huh, it's just like in the serials.
I wonder who used to live here. Do you suppose anyone remembers anymore?
Thank you.
always wanted to visit Stellar Bay. Taking the sights, the sounds, the... Wait, what's that smell?
You reckon a smell ever goes away? Maybe the wind off the sea helps.